Here's what you do to bad pizza, just throw it in the trash.
What's up, everybody out there? It's your boy JT, Sin City Food Reviews here. We're going on a crazy mission today. It's gonna be a vlog style food review. You guys are gonna absolutely love it, but I'm not gonna spill the beans. But let's head over to the place we're gonna check out today. All right, we're in the car. We're gonna call Boss Pizza on Arville Street. It was rated the worst pizza place on Yelp. So let's give it a shot. Let's see if it's definitely the worst pizza place. We're just gonna order a small meat lover's pizza. Is this Boss Pizza?
Yeah, how can I help you?
I want to order a pickup order.
Okay, what's your name?
JT.
Phone number. It's going to be cash or card?
Card.
What can I get for you?
How much is your small, the meat lover's pizza?
Okay. $17.25.
Okay, we'll take one of those and that'll do it for us. And how long?
Maybe about 20 minutes or less.
Okay, thank you. We'll see you then.
I'll do your card right now so I can just hand it to you and we don't need to do so many transactions.
I don't want to do my card over the phone, so I'll just meet you there. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Get the place. That sucks that everything's going on. I can't eat in here. Everybody keeps telling me this is the best place in town, so. All right, guys, we got the pizza. I tried to go inside, but they wouldn't let you go inside because of COVID going on, but created a little deception. I said, everybody said you got the best pizza place in town. She said, yeah, we make everything fresh. So let's check out the pizza and let's see, but we're gonna take it home and sample it and we're gonna give a completely honest review. Now, is Yelp right about the worst pizza place, or is Yelp wrong, or maybe they just had some bad experiences? It was quick. As soon as we got here, the pizza was ready.
Okay, here's the box it came in. All right, we did get a meat lovers. Check it out. Doesn't look too bad. It smells good. Doesn't look like there's a lot of cheese at the end. It was like $18 for this pizza, $17 for this pizza, so wasn't too bad. But let's go home and sample this pizza and give you guys an honest review.
20 minutes later.
Here is the pizza. You guys seen it a little bit. There's the pizza right there. It smells pretty good. It's not as hot as it was because we had to drive a little bit, but it looks pretty good. It looks like they clumped a lot of the toppings in one spot, but let's give it a shot. Let's see. And I'm gonna read off some of the bad reviews before we start digging into this pizza. Okay, the first review is from Kyle D. This is about 5 months ago. He said, expect a wait of 2 hours or more. I ordered one 18-inch deluxe pizza and three Gatorades. Total was $46. I tried to cancel after 2 hours. All of a sudden it's, oh, we tried to call you. Well, it didn't take us that long. There was no one there though. All right, Phoenix W says, this was the worst ever. First, I wait an hour and a half for my delivery, only for my order to be old and disgusting and not what I ordered, not to mention soggy. All right, well, it doesn't look too bad. All right, Jeff L. says, don't even bother, called an order in and was told an hour wait and figured that's not too bad. Fast forward 1 hour and 45 minutes later and still no pizza. So there's just a couple. Let's dig into the pizza and we'll read off a couple other reviews and we're gonna give our honest opinion. All right, so if you look right there, it looks like it's not really cooked that great. It is a little floppy. Mom slice. Okay, I'll try this one. All right, here's my slice. All right, let's get first impressions of this pizza. All right, let's take in. There's not much sauce on it. You can see right here. Kind of blurry a little bit, but not much sauce. The cheese tastes really crappy. I'm not gonna lie. The cheese is terrible. It tastes like it's like really generic, almost like Dollar Tree. I don't know if anybody's ever bought cheese from the Dollar Tree. It's like doesn't melt that good. The bottom is soggy. The only plus side is it's not greasy. Wow. There is like literally no sauce on this pizza. Like,
yeah.
You could see.
There's sauce on the edge.
Kind of hard to see, but there is really no sauce on this.
If you look in between
that. In between the slice, there's no sauce. All right, let's read a couple more reviews. All right, here we go. NYJ 2 months ago said, 0 stars, horrible service and horrible cold food. It is pretty cold, but we did drive. It's not warm though. You'd think it'd be warm. We didn't drive that far.
Right.
Received a flyer under the door at the hotel we were staying in and figured it'd be convenient. It took 2 hours to deliver, plus a $7 delivery fee. That is one thing. This pizza is way too expensive. $18 I paid for this little tiny pizza.
A small pizza.
The pizza was bland. That's definitely right. Raven R 3 months ago said the pizza was bland, just not good. Deal with $30.99 plus a $7. Yeah, it's way too expensive. That's the first thing for what you've got. All right, let's move along. All right, Chris D 4 months ago said, if I could give 0 stars, I would. They lied. They overcharged me, and the delivery driver yelled at me and called me an a-hole. Shortly after I checked into the Flamingo, I got a flyer underneath the door advertising this place. All right. Doughboy K, 9 days ago. 9 days ago. These are recent reviews. It's 3:30 a.m. First off, I ordered a turkey and cheese sandwich with onions and mayo. I ordered off Grubhub, and I stated I did not want any onions and light mayo. They gave me mayo and added tomatoes, which I'm allergic to. All right, Dominique M, 8 days ago, again said, this place is trash. Don't order from them. Food looks like nothing like the menu. Unflavored microwave food. It does taste. I'm going to be honest. It tastes like a frozen pizza that's been in like one of those like microwave oven things or whatever. It's not, it's really bad. It's not that bad. Like, I don't know if I'll even be able to finish these slices or whatever, but let's read a good review. There is a couple good reviews in here. Yelp gave it like 2 stars out of like hundreds and hundreds of reviews. All right, this might be a troll that wrote this one. Orgas A, I'm always ordered from Boss Pizza. This place making all good of the menu. Pizzas are so delicious, pastas are good, salads fresh, cheesecake and brownie my favorite. Well, this place ain't my favorite. It's not even in. I get a DiGiorno pizza and it tastes better than this garbage. All right, let's see if we can find another good review. There is a couple good reviews. Okay, here's one. David G, 7 months ago, said, best margarita pizza I've ever tasted. It is easy to get the margarita wrong. The dough comes out as wet and mushy, especially if the restaurant uses off-the-shelf ingredients, not this pizza. I can say for sure, but I think the sauce was made in-house. Well, if we had sauce,
there's no sauce
on it. You know what I'm saying?
Edge.
Oh, man. So
it's thick.
Dodo K, 7 months, said, I love this place. Was the first time checking in. Me and my kids love the Hawaiian pizza, which obviously we're not eating Hawaiian. Was very good, yummy, and extra cheese. There is a lot of cheese on here, but it's clumped in the middle.
Right.
It's really clumped in the middle. The atmosphere and the boss has nice attitude. The lady was super nice. Let's be honest with that. When I went and got my pizza, she was super nice. COVID, they won't let people come in the restaurant or whatever. So, but overall, Yelp, 2 stars. Boss Pizza, Arville Street, Las Vegas, Nevada. I think I'm gonna agree with everybody out there. Myself, I'm gonna give it 2 stars myself. Mom,
I would give it
1 star. What are we going for?
I'd say probably 1. I like sauce on my pizza. It seems dry.
And the ingredients, you could tell they've been frozen.
Yeah.
So,
it's like, I don't know.
For me, overall rating, I give it a 2. The only reason why I gave it a 2 is because the speed. It was there quick.
It was done.
We got there. The lady was super nice. I'd probably give it a 1. It tastes like some freezer burn pizza. Have you ever cooked a freezer burn pizza and threw it in the oven? That's what this tastes like. And Mom, would you recommend Boss Pizza?
No.
Absolutely.
Especially for the cost.
Yeah, absolutely not. I would
you
never recommend Boss Pizza.
Road.
I wanted to debunk the theory as Sin City Food Reviews. I was going to check out the worst rated pizza place in Las Vegas on Yelp. And it looks like I agree and Mom agrees with the ratings of 2 stars. And that's doing good, giving it 2 stars. Like that one guy said, it probably would have got a 1 if it wasn't quick. And another thing, the lady wanted to take my debit card over the phone. Like, I'm not paying over the phone. So I ended up getting cash back from a store. And that's how I ended up paying for this pizza. But I almost paid 20 bucks for this, which I probably won't eat the rest of it. So, much love to you guys. Thank you guys for watching. And next time, we're going to find the number 1 rated pizza restaurant on Yelp. And we're taking you guys on that journey. We are Sin City Food, and you have been reviewed.